These films date back in 1951, because my brother Richard, my sister Arlene, we called Chubby in those days. And we're at Palisades Amusement Park, which is no longer in existence. This was in New Jersey. And it was just a Sunday on the road with, there's Dad. 1951, Dad was, let's see, not even 40 years old. Isn't that something? He was born in 1913, so in 1953 he would have been 40, but he and Mom were partners in that year. In fact, she had joined him when he bought the store from Mike Matrone, his former partner. He bought him out. So Mom and Dad became partners, and they were working pretty hard, and this was one of the Sundays that where the family got together. Sundays was to go out with his brand new 51 Coupe de Ville. As I recall, we lived in the Bronx in those days. As I recall, he was the only one that had a car like that. And we used to put blankets on it during the week, and he used to take it out just on Sundays, believe it or not. I believe these were taken in 1952. There's Richie and there's Arlene into the street. As a boy, I remember the police coming by often and either giving him a ticket or giving him a warning that he was on public property with his stand. He was not supposed to be out that far. But he figured it was profitable enough to pay a ticket every now and then to have the food displayed, because the customers obviously would be more prone to buy. And here I am. Finally, I get into a picture. As you can see, pretty chunky. I guess here I was 12 years old. This was during the summer. And I was delivering orders. I think in the film you'll see me pushing a pushcart. Now here I have someone taking the film, and I'm actually going very slow to be sure that they get everything, and I'm giving orders here to make sure that they use the camera correctly. It's funny looking back. I guess I was proud of that camera. It was probably a year or two after this that I slimmed down a little bit anyway. But I used to love to eat. Being near the store, it was very easy. Very easy to eat. You can see all the old cars from the early 50s and late 40s on the road. Here's Dad taking an order from a good customer. Their dad was about 39 years old. It's funny when you think back, because here I am at 42, and Dad then was younger than I am right now. So it gives one a pause in thinking about that. May. And my grandmother, who by the way is 93 years old this year. In that picture, she was 63. And in the background, the older gentleman that you just saw with the mustache was my grandfather, who died in 1954. You can see Dad how tired he was after a very tough week at the store. He always had that unshaven look. Again, the family was kind of important. Maybe that's the Italian heritage, so to speak. And where you had the family, you had food. Here's Arlene, and here's Uncle Jim. I liked Uncle Jim a lot. Unfortunately, Ida and Jimmy are not married at this point. They were divorced a few years ago. And there is Joe Jr. in the act with the food. As you can see, I did like the food. I made sure I saved mine while I was picking on everybody else's. Here again, he's about 40 years old. It's hard to believe that I'm about that age right now. And here's Joe Jr. playing his accordion. Jarabe Tapatio, that's the Mexican hat dance. I guess after having dinner with the family, everybody wanted to hear a little music. And of course, Dad and Mom were spending money on this, and it was always nice to hear how it was progressing. And I started Fordham Prep just after this, and this confirms it, since this is my graduation from St. Martin of Tours School. And that's the street that I was born on. That is now considered, believe it or not, the South Bronx. Everything south of 190th Street, which is Fordham Road, is considered the South Bronx. And that wonderful building that we lived in is no longer there. Everything has deteriorated to the point where many of those buildings were knocked down, including 2164 Prospect Avenue. This is my 8th grade graduating class. And Mom was very careful to make sure I wore a carnation. So the family poses in front of the church, and we will be heading home in a few minutes to again celebrate with the family and food in the apartment that you saw for Thanksgiving. I think it's in this film that you get a better feel for what that apartment looked like. This is my 8th grade diploma. The school that you see in the background is a girls' school that my cousin Rose went to called Thomas Aquinas School, a high school for girls. That was the candy store on the corner. And just a couple of blocks away from the church is 2164 Prospect Avenue, and that's the building right there. Little Pamela was tough to control, and here she runs away, and someone very quickly taking the picture caught her just trying to run into the alleyway. But Richard was faster than she was, and he caught her. Here we are, enjoying food once again. And those were the backyards of the various buildings that were along the street. This is now 1954 for sure, June of 1954. Here's my grandfather. He was 74 at the time. He was quite older than my grandmother. And this was the trip I took in 1956 to Florida. I had never been on a plane before, and as you can see, I'm flying. And these were propeller planes. Kind of expanded my horizon. I've taken many, many trips to Florida since then. And here I am swimming, and one of them was nice enough to take my picture. This was that transitional stage I mentioned before, where I was starting to lose my baby fat and maturing. So I was about 15. I was turning 16 the month after I returned. Animals always fascinated me, so here I am holding a chimpanzee. That is a great shot. 16 years old. I was kind of concerned that he might do something. Again, must be about 1960, 61. Dad is proud as a peacock, having spent a nice, hard. Here I'm putting on some weight now. This looks like I'm in my early 20s, maybe 21, 22, so this could be 62, actually, or 63. And with the way my hair is cut, it could very well be that I was just coming back from Fort Dix, one of those Sundays I was given leave, which would make this 1963, somewhere between April and October. I did change over. Let's see, I bought another movie camera. I guess it was in the mid-60s. Another party. And here we have Carol Oliveri and Albert, who she married sometime later, and Tony. Tony and Arlene were getting married later on that year, so they were engaged here. Some other friends that came, Bonnie, Eddie Montenegro, and Joe Bold. And this was in the basement of the house we bought in Westchester. There's Janice Jerry, a girl that I used to go out with. In fact, we were probably with each other that night. And there's my famous 1960 Corvette, which I love so well.